welcome to another series of Paddles Up, where the world's top canoeists pit their wits and their skills against hazards which are both natural and some of them devised by our course designers. This is the fifth series of Paddles Up, and we've come back to North Wales, to the River Dee at picturesque Llangollen. Now, this is probably the strongest field ever assembled for Paddles Up. There are five world champions, and supplying our expert comment, as ever, our resident expert, John Gosling, General Manager of the British Slalom Teams. John, first of all, tell us a little bit about this formidable field.
Well, I'm so pleased this year. We've actually turned away some foreign paddlers. We've got, as you say, five world champions, including the three British men who won the gold medal. Liz Sharman, the defending Paddles Up champion and now the world champion. Elizabeth Mittler, who won a world team. We've got six silver medals from the world championships and two bronze medalists from the world championships, apart from having the junior paddlers in it this year, who won the pre-worlds and second in the pre-worlds in men's. The ladies' field is incredibly strong. It's just tremendous. It's so pleasing.
All right, without any more ado, let's go up to the start and have a rundown on the paddlers in heat one.
Sean Pearce, age 17, the British junior champion. Janez Skak, former Yugoslav national champion, silver medal in World Championships team event. Jimmy Jays, former British champion, British team champion, third paddles up. Jerni Abramic, Yugoslavia, silver medal in individual and team events at the World Championships. Wouter Koopmans, ranked third in Holland, and at 19 years of age, a name for the future. 20-year-old Ian Raspin, ranked two in Britain, a member of Britain's World Championship team. Russ Smith, top-ranking Britain World Championship team winner. Iri Pultera, former Czech champion and first representative from the Eastern Bloc to take part in Paddles Up. So, getting ready to launch this year's Paddles Up, Sean Pearce, age 17, the British junior champion, and what a wicked start, because from that slide he goes to the roll gate, just the sort of thing to clear away any hangovers early in the morning, and beautifully negotiated that by this young man who's ranked seventh in Britain. Now he goes across and does the 360-yard degree turn, and that's a good start for him, John Gosling.
Certainly is, yeah. Round the orange pole there, 360-degree. Now down to the pirouette gate, where he has to put the back of the boat underwater and try and hit the ball with the front of the boat, Chris.
And this has caused mayhem and no little amusement in the past. He's missed on the first attempt. Now he's got to have a minimum of two attempts. He's missed with his first. He's going to try again. Of course, every time he misses, he's wasting seconds.
That's right. He's wasting a lot of time here. He's forgetting now. He just gets a 5-second penalty if he hits or misses anything. So he's got a 5-second penalty there as he goes over to the targets.
So five penalty points and seconds for Sean Pearce. He has no problem with the first of the two targets or the second. And so he's going and perhaps just steadying himself slightly now as he goes down the course.
That's right, yeah. This is called the serpent's tail, and we'll see why at the end of the course on the rough water. But Sean now going down to the limbo gates here. He has to duck under the two limbo gates and try not to hit them.
He's reckoned to be one of the most promising youngsters in the country, ranked eighth, as I say, in the overall rankings in Britain. He now goes across to the second of the 360-degree turns, and this one, John, a lot harder than the first.
That's right. It's on the stopper wave, which is the wave that turns back on itself, riding the stopper there tremendously well, actually. Sean doing well through the green gate, which is a downstream gate, clears that, and now under a very difficult limbo above the tail.
Well, he's recovering marvellously from the pirouette, which really cost him a lot of time. But now here's another exciting little novelty with the hoop, and he's got to get this going through very fast water, as you can see, and he's having a little bit of trouble. He's trying to get his paddle through the hoop, but he's missed that too.
Yeah, he's feeling tired, I think. He wasted time up the top, and he's lost his concentration slightly. But now he has to come down. You see the foaming white water there. If they make a mistake, they're in real trouble. And now to the last of the 360-degree gates. The pole here over in the eddy where the slack water is moving now out of the slack, back into the fast water towards the finish.
Well, the water just absolutely perfect at this time of year, though, although it has been a very hard season. They're coming to the end, John, and the concentration, as you say, may just be wavering. But he's finished, and his time, 2 minutes 15.32 with 10 penalty points. Next off, the first of the three Yugoslavs in the field, Janez Skak, aged 24, his second paddles up. He didn't have a very happy time last year, John, and I reckon from what we've seen of Sean Pearce, the course is even harder than it was last year.
That's right. Oh, and he gets a five there on the roll gate, hits it with his paddle coming up, but he's now down to this 360-degree pole. And as you say, as Sean proved, at the bottom where that tail comes in, the serpent's tail, the whip at the finish seems to be causing the real problems, but the pirouette, I think, is where Sean lost it.
Well, already 5 seconds a penalty for Janez Skak, but no problem with the pirouette. He did that quite beautifully.
Yeah, just clipped it, and I think the top lads will be doing a bit better than Sean did there, but no trouble with the targets there. Makes it look very simple. The paddlers seem to be able to handle the targets and have trouble with things like the limbos and the pirouette.
Well, it's been a very hard start, but he's certainly negotiating the last few obstacles very well indeed as he comes up now to the limbos, the first of the three limbos, and without any question the hardest one is yet to come.
That's right, yeah. Oh, and he gets another five, so that's 2 fives so far as he comes down to this 360 degree turn, round the pole, and then rides this stopper wave again.
So 10 penalty points for Skuk, and he's 12th in the World Championships, had a very good World Championships across that stopper wave, and did that very well indeed now, coming down to the third of the limbos, and you could see the power of that wave.
Yeah, and this is where he'll come through now on the big white water. He's a very good white water paddler. Through that gate there, no trouble. Down towards the tube, but he's having trouble. They were trying to do this in one move, and they're really, he's taking the safe option there as he comes down now through into the tail section, stuck in the slack water there. The eddy again, having trouble with the biles, but moving into the 360, wasting time though, the time's ticking on.
But a very, very fast section of water that, John. Must be exceptionally difficult this time of the year to negotiate.
Yeah, now he's coming down to the finish. I think he's got 10 seconds and his time there, 156.10 plus 10 second penalties.
That's Jimmy Jays, one of the most experienced paddlers in the field, age 29, his third paddles up, and that's the time he has to beat, to the 206.10 seconds of Janez Skuk from Yugoslavia. Jimmy Jays, a mercurial paddler, at his best he's pretty well unbeatable, but he's had some horrors here over the years, John.
That's right, yeah, he's a local lad, he lives in Llangollen now, he moved up here, and really he's paddling on his home water, and I know JJ is out to do well. You see he's taken a different route to the ball, he's gone left foot towards the pirouette. The paddler's got various ideas. Oh, and he's missed it.
Well, a little bit of local knowledge there didn't help him, and he's wasting time here just as young Sean Pierce did in the first, but he's got it the second time, so probably worth his while to just waste those few seconds. But he has wasted quite a bit of time as he comes down now to the first of the targets, and that really has thrown him, John.
Yeah, I think we'll see JJ now really open up towards these gates. Skuk took it very slow indeed. JJ opening his stroke pattern up there, moving down towards the limbos, paddling very hard. They don't want to use too much energy on this part of the course, Chris, but they've got to keep the boat moving at all times.
Ranked fifth in the country and 18 years in the sport, so he certainly has a wealth of experience. But there you see he just clipped that second of the limbo boards, and now he goes across to this very, very difficult stretch of water, the 360 degree turn, and then across the stump.
That's right, yeah, the wave, it turns back on itself, so it holds the boat for them. It helps the paddlers a lot, that does. If they fall off that, that's where they lose time. Under that limbo gate, tremendously well there. And now JJ, we'll see if he'll go for the straight move where he passes his paddle through the tyre and keeps going in a straight line. But he's angled slightly wrong there.
Well, it's defied the previous two. He's got himself tied up, but he's all right. He certainly got through. Remember, though, he wasted time at the pirouette, and he's got five penalty points so far, although he's negotiating this okay at the moment.
Yeah, he's got the time of 2:06.1 to beat, and he's got 5 second penalty, and I think he's going to go into the lead there, Chris.
Yes, a good finish for Jimmy Jays, so after a promising start, so he's come good at the end. This is Jernej Abramovic from Yugoslavia, one of the world's outstanding paddlers, age 23 and the silver medalist in the World Championships in 1987, but he's made a terrible mess of getting in off the slide. He goes under the roll gate, and even there he's having a little bit of trouble, so a most unpromising start for this man who won the silver medal, ranked 2 in the world.
That's right, yeah, got the silver medal at the Worlds, and these Yugoslavians have been training quite hard for this paddles up, and I think we'll see the best of him towards the bottom end of this course. He's gone the same way as Jimmy Jays, and let's see if he can get this pirouette. I mean, JJ made a mistake. Oh, and he held the boat down there, kept the stern of the boat down, coming up high now across the moving water towards the targets, trying to keep the boat moving at all times, which is the art of slalom canoeing. And now he's moving down to the limbo gates. He'll be working hard now.
The time to beat to Jimmy Jays, 2:02.28. And although he wasted a little bit of time early on, he hasn't incurred any penalty points, and he's certainly making up for lost time now. That's Jernej Abramovic from Yugoslavia. Best performance, incidentally, second ever by a Yugoslav in the World Championship. So he's a superb paddler, and now he really is going, John.
Yeah, keeping the boat moving, coming down now into this the stopper riding section, and he's fallen off now, so he's going to be losing time. He's going to have to work very hard to get back up to this green gate.
5 penalty points then incurred by Abramovich, and he's already just lost a little bit of ground again. He's under the third of the limbo gates, and now let's see if he can do what the other paddlers haven't yet been able to achieve and get through this in one without making any mistakes. That was neatly done.
Yeah, he turned the boat slightly, so he's lost a bit of time, but he's doing well. The 5 he picked up there on the limbo gate, just touched it slightly, lost the stern of the boat there. Now he's going to have to move. His time's good though, he's got 5 seconds, but I don't think he's going to beat Jimmy Jayce's time.
So the finishing time for Abramovich, 2:06.4 plus 5 penalties. Next off for the Norwich Union Paddles Up Trophy, Wouter Koopmans from Holland, aged 19 and ranked 3rd in the country, again reckoned to be one of the most promising in that country, but John Gosling, really very much the learners at this sport.
That's right, yeah, they're the up-and-coming nation, really. They have a guy called Bernd Depe who's moved from Germany to be their national coach, and he's doing a tremendous job in encouraging them and bringing them on within the world rankings. But
I shouldn't imagine they have much water like this in Holland. In fact, they were saying that most of the top men have to go to Germany and Belgium for practice, and he did that exceptionally well. In fact, I think the best we've seen as far as the pirouette's concerned.
That's right, yeah. I tell you, it could be a dark horse. He could come through. I mean, he's really smashing the targets there.
He's making a tremendous start. He's certainly made the fastest start without any mistakes so far, and a most encouraging start for this 19-year-old.
Yeah, and the interesting thing is, Chris, on this course, we thought it'd be a 90-second course, i.e. 1.5 minutes, and they're taking 2 minutes. It's quite interesting. The paddlers are easing off and trying to do it clear, which is the art of the slalom canoeist, but they all seem to be picking up. There's a 5 there, his first penalty. The limbo gates are causing them problems.
Well, that was a shame, because he's been going very well, still chasing Jimmy Jay's total of 2:02.28. No one's bettered that so far, and he did not terribly well in the World Championships, 49th, and he's doing incredibly well here, coming across that stopper way.
Oh, but he's below the green gate. He's having trouble. He's having to work to get up, because if he doesn't do the gate... Oh, he did well there, came up. Doesn't matter if he does it forwards or backwards, as long as it's a downstream move.
That'll teach me to see he's doing incredibly well. Just at that, he seemed to lose the place a little bit, and he seems to have lost his rhythm. And lose his rhythm he most certainly did, and finished in a most disappointing time, 2:37.53. There's a familiar face, Ian Raspin, 20-year-old, 3rd paddles up. He's ranked number 2 in Britain, and in he went with a splash right up to the roll gate. He's having a marvellous season, John.
Yeah, he's been out abroad representing Britain. He was in the 87 World Championship team. He's having a tremendous season. In fact, he's having a tremendous career within slalom canoeing.
He was a member of the championship team, won the gold medal in the World Championships, but he's making a little bit of heavy weather now as he comes across to try the pirouette, but he got that beautifully.
Yeah, we sent 4 men to the 87 Worlds. Ian was the 4th paddler, and although he didn't receive a medal, he was out there, but we look at it, the team go out, the team work as a team, not just men, ladies, everyone. And Ian now going down. I know he's confident. When we were talking about the possible winners here, Ian wasn't mentioned, but I tell you, in this heat one, there's some very, very strong young paddlers.
And it's a bit of a family affair here this year, because later on we have Ian's younger brother, Andrew, who will be competing, and he just clipped the second of the limbo gate, so 5 penalty points are there to Ian Raspin.
Yeah, this second limbo gate here. Alan Edge really designed the course with myself this year up here, and the limbo gates were quite excited, but we thought they wouldn't create too many problems, but they really aren't. This is the limbo gate we thought would be trouble, and they're clearing it. But, you know, you just can't tell.
You're the masochist, are you? We have to blame for this. Well, certainly, it's been a most exciting course, and they're having their problems. And here, Ian seems to be in a little bit of difficulty as he comes up to the hoop, but he got away with that very well.
Yeah, really powered on there. As he was coming down, I thought he was in the wrong position, put the power on. Now he's moving from the fast to the slack, and now he has to drive the boat across to get that last gate and come down to the finish. Very good time here, Chris. I think we're going to have a new leader.
A marvellous time. Remember, 2:02.28, the target to beat by Jimmy Jayce. And that's a marvellous time for Ian Raspin. 1:50.01 plus just 5 penalty points, and that puts him into the lead. And that's Russ Smith, the top-ranking Briton, age 23, a gold medal in the World Team Championships and having a magnificent season as he comes up to the first of the obstacles. And he hits that, so that's five penalty points straight off and a discouraging start for Britain's number one, John.
Yeah, Russ was hoping to do really well at this event and hopefully he won't let that affect his performance here as he comes round the 360-degree pole and down towards the pirouette. He's working hard and he's been practicing the pirouette, as all the paddlers have, but he was too far away. Getting on the second attempt very well indeed there now as he drives across the moving water and towards the targets. Going well, he's keeping the boat moving, which is the art, and he takes the one target there, concentrates, just notices, he looks at that target as he hits it, Chris, and then moves on downstream.
So recovering nicely from that first gate, and going on now to the first of the limbos, the three limbos that face the paddlers. The first one hasn't caused many problems, but the second certainly has.
Yeah, through the first one, no trouble at all. This is the one where they keep clipping it, and it's very difficult. Oh, and he does it clear, makes it look simple. In fact, he just leapt back, but that's where the problems have been. He now comes up to this orange pole, the 360 degree, to ride the stopper, and they drive across, and you see Russ using experience there, falls off the stopper, the wave that turns back on itself, and drives now back up through the green gate to go downstream to the third limbo, no trouble at all, and now moves on down to the tail.
Russ Smith from Barnard Castle near Darlington, so he's coming up now to this very dangerous closing stages, and the idea to get the paddle through the ring here, and oh, real trouble for Russ Smith, and that's where Russ Smith lost it. He finished in a time of 2:08.38, including five penalty points. And here's a little bit of history for us, because this is the first ever Czechoslovakian paddler to take part in Paddles Up. He's Jiří Pultera, a former Czech national champion, and it's marvellous to see him, although not a very good start for him, John.
Yeah, but he's an experienced paddler, and I don't think it will get to him. As we saw Russ Smith carry on down there, the paddlers are having trouble with this roll gate, and he's moved round the 360 degree pole there and moves on down to the pirouette. And it'd be interesting to see how he does this, because the Eastern Bloc countries tend to have slightly different techniques and styles, and they're, you know, completely rung approach. The British paddlers have done Paddles Up for a few years now. This is the first time we've had an Eastern Bloc country paddler in, and he's a bit confused. Oh, he's caught up on the rocks there, completely the wrong position.
Yes, well, you're just, as you were saying, just a total lack of experience about these particular disciplines. And I suppose that that's not a discipline you use all that often in competitive paddling.
Not that often, and certainly not having the precision of knowing where the nose of the boat is to hit the ball. The pirouette move is a common used move, but not in the way we use it in Paddles Up.
So a disappointing start then for Pultera, but let's see what he can do on the latter part of the course.
Yeah, he's moving down now to the limbos. Again, strange area, so he was very weary there, but he's keeping the boat moving and he's trying to keep the... Oh, and just didn't go down far enough.
And so problems continued to pile up for Pultera at 32, the oldest in the field. He had a courageous run, but in the end, the course proved too demanding and he finished in a time of 2:36.31, including 15 penalty points. So the times after the first heat, the leader Ian Rutsman, 1:55.01. Second Jimmy Jays, 2:02.28. Abramich, 2:05.64. Skuk, 2:06.10. Smith, 2:08.38. Pierce, 2:25.32. Pultera, 2:36.31. And last, Koopmans from Holland, 2:37.53. And so the first section of Heat 1 completed. The paddlers now know what they're in for. And we pick up the second section with the first of the serious contenders for place in the final, Janez Skuk from Yugoslavia. He's making his way now straight across to the snake gates and getting through the first two all right, John.
Yeah, oh, and a clip one there, I think. And he does the pirouette move now to come back across this stream. They're really having to work. The 60-second course, having a two-minute course of the first half, is really making these lads try and work hard to catch up with Ian Rutsman, who was a 1:55.01. But the time to beat is the 3:01.62 of Russ Smith. Oh, and he's in trouble now. He's really low on that target. Little Stocky isn't going to be happy with that.
I think you realise the full force of that water, John, when these expert paddlers are taking so much to get back if they lose the way.
That's right, yeah. I mean, what you're seeing here is the cream of the world. And they can make it look very simple, and I think we're proving now that the courses on Paddles Up are getting more and more difficult. He's going towards the finish line now anyway.
So Scott going towards the finish and up and over. So he's completed that all right. 3:03.94 and a clear run. The second of the Yugoslavs in this heat, Jernej Abramić, who has Russ Smith's target of 3:01.62 to beat. And off he goes on the gates.
Yeah, he's moving quite nice. He's done that very nice indeed. See, he's just spinning the boat now, and now we'll see power. He's turning the power on now to really work to get across there. He's got a few, 3 seconds over Smith after the first half of the heat, but anything can happen. We saw his fellow countryman there miss the second target and have to come back for it, and it's cunningly right in. Alan Edge, who's designed the second half of the course on his own, has really worked hard at moving these targets into position. He was so upset that they got the first half easy. Anyway, it's 2:45, time's counting on, and he's clear at the moment, Chris.
I notice you're taking no responsibility for this, John, and this is a marvellous run by Abramić. He's through the final gate and now quickly going towards the line, the finishing line. This is a superb time. Is he going to beat it? It's up, paddles up, and he's taken the lead. 3:01. Jimmy Jay is lying second after the first section, and how dearly he would love to do well in this paddles up after his previous experiences, John.
Yeah, and he's actually on literally his home water here. He trains 7 days a week on this site, and I know he's been involved in actual designing in certain ways with this course, but JJ didn't want to have too much to do with it. He wanted to prove he could get through to the final, and I'm pushing for him. I really want him to be there.
Well, on his day, as we've said before, he can beat the best. He's having a little bit of trouble, I noticed, on the snake, but he's incurred no fault so far. Going across now to the targets, getting his boat mixed up in the edge there.
Yeah, the thing here now, and we've seen it in the past with the paddles up event, that when you feel as though you're far enough ahead that you can ease off towards the finish, and the mistakes at the end are the things that are crucial. He's made it look very simple now. He's coming back across this wave towards the last gate. He's just got one target that, you know, the paddles up to clear now.
So on he goes now to the finish. It's a good time. Paddles up, and he's taken the lead. 2:59.9 for Jimmy Jays. Ian Ruspin going for this Norwich Union title, leading the heat after the first section, and he knows now what he has to do. Jimmy Jays with that marvellous time, and only two remember going through from each heat. So it's a very important that young Ian gets off to a good start here, John.
Yeah, and I think this is where, if there's going to be problems, it'd be the snake, and they're clearing it nicely. I've just noticed there's 6 seconds between Smith and Jays. So, I mean, Jimmy went very slowly on his, and Ian has to be careful not to do that. He's gone wide there, he's eased off. He might blow it if he's not careful. There's very little in this.
Well, he's now going to approach, without any question, the hardest part. No problems, though, so far at the targets. He's coming across the most difficult part yet.
Yeah, and 2:33, 2:34, the time's clicking on. The finish line is further than you imagine. He can't afford to hit a gate, but likewise, he can't afford to go too slowly.
Well, let's see what he does. It's all going to be on this finish. It's not a bad time. And up and over, and oh, he's done it very nicely indeed. 2:49.20 and a clear run for Ian Ruspin. He leads the heat. So the two who go through from this heat into the final, Ian Ruspin, 2:49.20, and Jimmy Jays, 2:59.97.
So the end of the first heat, and we've seen some marvellous paddling. Great results too for the British boys, Jimmy Jays and Ian Ruspin. The second heat brings...
Megan. Mm-hmm. Megan, I can't stay. I've got to start early. You know that.
Why not start now?
I shouldn't have done it like that this time. And now we can't afford a baby now.
Oh, Luke, just once isn't gonna matter. Or even twice, so long as you know what you're doing. I'll read up on it.
Welcome back to Paddles Up on the misty River Dee at Llangollen. We've got two finalists so far, Ian Raspin, ranked two in Great Britain, and the local boy from Llangollen, Jimmy Jays. We're now going to find out who's coming through from Heat 2. It's the strongest heat surely ever assembled for Paddles Up, so without any more ado, let's go up to the start and have a rundown on the paddlers for Heat 2.
Andy Raspin, 18-year-old brother of Ian, third in European Junior Championships. Ian Wiley from Dublin, the Irish national champion. Melvin Jones, world team champion, slalom sprint champion, fifth paddles up. Marjan Strukel, third of the Yugoslavs, bronze medal in the World Championships. Michael Reyes from Holland, the Dutch number one. Peter Mickler, former world team champion, runner-up to Richard Fox in last year's paddles up. Richard Fox, three times world champion, European champion, and defending paddles up champion. And so to start us off on Heat 2, Andy Raspin, 18 years of age and younger brother of Ian. Father Don Raspin, a great influence on both these boys, and he must be so proud of both of them. They're doing so well. But having said that, Andy's clobbered the very first in the roll gate, and a bit of a discouraging start for him, John Galton.
Yeah, the Chris Ray kiss of death came in there, Chris. It's round the 360-degree pole there now, and he's moving down. And as we saw in the first heat, the pirouette gate didn't cause as much problem as we thought, but Andy there did it very nicely indeed. The main thing Andy will be out to do here is beat his brother's time in the first heat. It'll be quite interesting to see as he moves down towards the targets here.
Well, he's got some way to go to do that. And Ian, remember, leading the first heat in the times. And young Andy, third in the European Junior Championships in Austria in 87. He's having a marvellous season.
Yeah, Andy moving down now towards these limbo gates. Under the first one, he's approaching. Doesn't seem to cause too many problems. It's the second one, if you remember, we had in the heat one that caused the problems there and causes it in heat two.
Yes, he's knocked into that one as well, but going along on a good angle around this 360-degree turn, just getting held up again. The water's so strong.
Yeah, coming across that stopper wave there, that's the wave that turns back on itself and should be holding him, and he's drifting downstream, but he fought back there. The young lad there coming down, Andy, under the limbo gate there now, moving down towards the tail. I mean, people have to remember, he's 18, he's got his whole future in canoeing ahead of him.
And he's made such rapid strides this season. He was 74th in the British rankings. He's through that very nicely, and he's come up now to 10th in the rankings. So really a young man of great promise.
And a tremendous time here, 150. He's not going to beat his elder brother's time in the first heat, but he's putting up a very respectable time here and something for him to aim at.
He's certainly not disgraced the family name with that run. And he now finishes in a time of 2:01.93 plus 10 penalty points. Now we have Ian Wiley from Ireland, the Irish national champion, 19 years of age, 13th at the World Championships, a very creditable finish for this young man. Coming up now to the roll gate, which caused young Raspin a few problems, but not so for Ian Wiley. He's through that and going well.
Yeah, and followers of paddles up that might remember a guy called Shane Kelly, who was in the very first one here in Llangollen. And Shane had a big influence on this young lad in his early career, in his early paddling career. And Ian is very much like Shane in his attitude and so on. Comes to the pirouette there, no trouble at all. I do fancy this guy perhaps pipping Mickler or Fox in this heat.
Well, he's certainly made a most impressive start, and this is some impressive heat that he's in. One of some of the greatest paddlers in the world in this heat, and he's doing exceptionally well in the opening stages, going very nicely indeed. Silver medal in the Junior World Championships in 1986, and trains, he was telling me, on the Liffey. I can't imagine that it's quite as fearsome as this.
No, it's not quite as big as this, but they are developing that actual course. And oh, he picks at that limbo gate, he's really causing some problems. Coming down now to the 360-degree pole, round it, no trouble, into the stopper wave there, riding across it quite well indeed, actually. He's done, almost loses it, but does it well now. Has to accelerate now at this limbo gate. Eases, goes for it now, going down towards the tail.
Well, still picked up just the 5 penalty points, so he's going very much on course. And now coming up to the rubber ring, which has caused problems in the past. He seems to have got himself a little bit off course and in trouble again.
Yeah, he had the time of Andy Raspin to beat, remember, in the second heat now. And the thing is, he's doing well, but he's having trouble here. I watched him in practice, Chris, and he was having trouble down here as well. and we only allow him one run down the course, but he seems to have blown it on this bottom bit, but a respectable time.
Yes, he still just shows if he hadn't got himself into trouble there, he was going to have a marvellous time.
So Ian Wiley finishes in a time of 2 minutes, 0.271, with 5 penalty points, and takes the lead in the second heat.
Melvin Jones, age 23, gold medalist in the World Championship team for Britain, into the start of this paddles up.
Yeah, approaching the roll gate. There's a lot of comments on this roll gate of where they actually roll, Chris, and as long as they roll around the roll gate area, that is okay. You know, we're not saying they have to be underwater going under the gate, because it's hard enough to come down that slide and go straight into a roll. I mean, we're sitting in a nice commentary box, but these guys are on a freezing cold river.
Well, he's no stranger to paddles up. He did that very well in the pirouette, and of course he's no stranger to it. This is his fifth. He's been a constant member of the paddles up team, so it's lovely to see him back, and certainly going well now.
I thought he'd missed that target. You see, he just flipped it with his paddle as he went past. Melvin comes from a tremendous family. The whole family give him backing, you know, as he goes down, and he's done tremendously well in training. A lot of paddlers train full-time and are virtually professionals, although they are amateurs, but they spend all the time. Oh, and there's a five for Melvin as well. But Melvin's held down a job while he trained for the 87 Worlds, and now he's gone full-time paddling while sort of working, shall we say.
Technically very sound slalom sprint champion coming across now the stopper wave, round that with no difficulty, and making his way at all speed towards the limbo, and again no difficulty there, but he's got now into the fast water and to get through this ring, and that really has been causing problems, as we've seen, and it really seems to be a raging torrent there.
Yeah, Melvin did that very well indeed. I know Melvin and Richard Fox were talking before this heat and discussing that gate between them and saying what they were going to do, and he's got a very respectable time here, much more like the time we thought we'd be seeing.
Well, only 5 penalty points, remember, and he seems to have negotiated the worst part. I daren't say that because sure as fate, no, he's finished marvellously well. 1 minute 46.21, 5 penalty points and the clear leader. And here we have Marijan Štrukul, the third of the Yugoslav paddlers in the field, third in the World Championships, and at 23, one of the outstanding paddlers in the world.
Yeah, coming down now into the roll gate. Coming down now, hard down towards the 360-degree pole here. He picked up the bronze medal at the World Championships. He's done tremendously well, silver medalist in the team. Coming down now to the pirouette, I think we'll see this lad open up and really start moving. 23, but a real flyer.
They have a marvellous technique.
Yeah, they base themselves on the British, the Yugoslavians, and they picked us at the last Worlds by taking 2 of the 3 medals, but we picked them in the team event, and one of the reasons they've come over to Paddles Up, they want to do the event, but they also want to study more British paddling as well.
Second then in the team event in the World Championships, this is Štrukul. Under that, now we'll see what he can make of the second, and again, once again, that has caused so many problems for the previous paddlers.
Yeah, and he clipped it with his paddle, actually. He cleared it with his body, and into that. You notice some of the top paddlers are actually pulling themselves off this stopper wave here and going below it, then using more energy, but they feel that they can do it faster. Now he's down to the last of the limbos in this half of the course and moving down to the tail. Looks to be a slow time, but they can. It's all on this crunch move with this passing the paddle through the hoop.
So Štrukul down the stream he comes up to the hoop, and he was performing a marvellous feat of gymnastics there, and he's got away with it, got himself out of trouble there as he comes now down to the 360 degree turn and making his way down to the finish. He's going hard for the finish, but he's not going to better Melvin Jones's time. He finishes 1 minute 52.02 with 5 penalty points. Michael Reyes is the next man off, a 21-year-old from Holland. He's ranked number one in Holland, but lives and trains in Dusseldorf in West Germany, and that's no doubt what has helped him greatly in his practicing. Finished 34 in the World Championships and is a student in Munich. John?
Yeah, he's coming down now, and I think he's learnt a lot. The paddlers help each other on these courses, and he's round that pole without any trouble at all now. Moving down to the pirouette gate, which is the easy thing. I mean, I wonder if going through the mine when they get to this pirouette gate is the limbo gate, you know, because that is proving to be the real problem. He seems to be powering quite hard here. It's so deceiving watching modern paddlers, because you could tell in the old days, you could tell by the speed the paddle strokes are moving, but now it's all about power. And he's making his boat move there, and as I said, Bernd Deppe is the national coach now in Holland, and he's had a tremendous influence on these guys.
Well, we've seen so many disasters in past years at the Pirouette, but coming up now is the gate that's causing all the problems. Let's see what Michael Reyes can do with it. Oh, and yet again, it's always becoming inevitable that we have penalty points here. Michael Reyes incurred 5 penalty points and just lost the place momentarily as he comes across the stopper wave.
Yeah, quite a respectable time. Fighting the stopper wave there, loses it a bit at the bottom, but moves it back. We haven't had a clear run yet in first or second heat. It'll be interesting to see what the last two lads can do, but back to this lad coming down here, Mike.
Once again, the one we thought was going to catch them all out, he's managed to negotiate. Now he comes down to this thrilling manoeuvre and the most difficult obstacle, although quite a few have managed it in varying stages of difficulty, but he's done that very well indeed, and he now comes across. Look at the determination there on the face of Michael Reyes and the power that's required to get yourself across that fast water.
Yeah, he's having to work now. It's a respectable time, though. It could be under 2 minutes if he puts a burn onto the finish line.
And anything under 2 minutes certainly is that. He's finished 158.98 with just 5 penalty points. Peter Mickler in his third paddles up, going for the Norwich Union title. Runner-up, remember, to Richard Fox last year. Finished a disappointing 7th in this year's World Championships, but my goodness, John, what a fine competitor he is.
Yeah, and he actually really loves paddles up, Peter, does he? He came over the first time for it and didn't really know what it was all about. And now he's the biggest promoter of it. I phoned him up and said, do you want to come over? And he was actually on the plane before I'd even finished the phone call.
And he's keeping up this family connection, because later on we have his sister Elizabeth taking part. And he's having problems though at the Pirouette, which he must have plenty of experience of now, but got it the second time, and he really is looking most confident despite his hiccup there.
Yeah, Peter hasn't been doing much training. Oh, it took it with the front of the boat. The cheek of the man, as they say. Peter,
another Pirouette. I think he obviously liked it so much.
Yeah, he obviously thought about that. He's moving down, he wants to beat Fox, he wants to do well, but Peter now, let's see if he can do this limbo game.
It's interesting, I was speaking to him and he was saying that his last competitive event was some 6 weeks ago, so he may be a little bit rusty, but he's going very well at the moment.
He's clear up to now. We could have a first clear run. I mean, he's so determined. I mean, he's going to kick himself about the Pirouette. He's always off the stopper there. He's going to have to work incredibly hard now, using up energy he didn't really want to use. Let's see if he can do the passing the ball through the hoop in one move as he goes under that pirouette, the limbo.
Well, he's still going well, despite wasting a little bit of time going across that stopper. Doing very well indeed. No penalty points incurred. He seems to have lost a little bit of his course there, his line, but he's doing that well. He'll have to recover now, turn and go across to the 360 degree turn, but still things going well, although once again now he's lost the place and wasting time.
Yeah, but it's under 150 at the moment. I think we could have a new leader as he comes down. He's coming into that gate there. Oh, and he hits the last gate.
Just a little lapse in concentration. Melvin Jones's time still stands. Mickler finished 1 minute 58.39 with 5 penalty points and just a little bit of loss of concentration towards the end. And last in this heat, but by no means least, Richard Fox, the man they all want to beat, the defending champion, 3 times former world champion, and out really to avenge that disappointing performance in the World Championships when he finished 4th. He had problems early in the season with a rib injury, which disrupted his early season training, but he's back at his best now and absolutely determined, and you can see it on that face, John.
Yeah, Fox has got the best face in the world when he's paddling. Coming down now. He was actually asking for the pirouette gate at the start of the event to be higher. Oh!
I don't know why then, because he's made an awful mess of it. And he's wasting time. Now he's getting himself set. And he's still having problems. And what's he going to do? Well, he's had his 2 shots at it. He's deciding to waste no more time. But 5 penalty points incurred there and quite a bit of time wasted. So not a good start for Richard Fox, the defending champion.
No, he's going steady. I mean, Fox, I would have put my money on for clearing the course. But that's the way it goes, isn't it? Let's see if he can get these limbo gates. If you remember last year, he won the final on the limbo section because he was the only man to clear them. Very good at limbo move, but let's wait and see.
This is the one that's been catching them all out. Oh, marvellous. Well, there's no problem with a rib injury there. I think if he'd had any problems with his rib, it would have sprung on that occasion. He almost bent back double. Marvellous grip of the water, this man. So beautifully balanced and smooth. It's just a joy to watch him come down.
Yeah, just takes it nicely. Doesn't seem to be paddling hard, but always has his boat moving. The art of slalom canoeing, you keep your boat moving all the time. I'll be interested to see if he does do the one move here, or if he looks to be lining up to take the eddy move, which means he's going to go into the slap.
Yes, that was neatly done. Now he crosses to the 360-degree turn. Remember the five penalty points incurred and quite a few seconds wasted at the pirouette, which he failed. But it's still a respectable time as he comes down now towards the finish, challenging Melvin Jones. But he's not going to do that. And he finishes in 156.48 and five penalty points to add to that. So the halfway stage in Heat 2, Melvin Jones, 151.21. Marian Struko from Yugoslavia, 157.02. Richard Fox, 201.48. Peter Mickler, 203.39. Michael Reyes, 203.98. Ian Wiley, 205.71. And Andy Ruspin, 211.93. We pick up the second section with the first of the serious contenders for a place in the final. Ian Wiley, the Irish champion, hoping to make up for lost time after a disappointing first section, but John Gosling, it's a pretty forlorn hope.
Yeah, he's got a lot to do, but if we remember, go back to Heat 1, Russ Smith was 8 seconds up on Jimmy Jays on this second half of the course. Even though it's about a 60-second course, anything can happen. That's the name of the game in Paddles Up. It's a fun competition that everyone wants to win.
So Ian Wiley making his way to the gate and then across for the targets, which haven't so far presented any problem, although seconds, fraction of seconds have been lost, but he did that nicely and coming across now to this very, very demanding part of the course.
Yeah, if we recall, this is the section that is copied from the World Championships that are held in Bourg-Saint-Maurice. And Ian was at those World Championships, he must know the move, he knows it probably in his sleep he could do it. Now he's sprinting down towards the finish line, it looks like he might break 3 minutes.
Very respectable time indeed for Ian Wiley. He just got the paddle up and over, finishing 2:56.54 and a clear run. So Michael Reyes, 21-year-old from Holland, hoping to make up for lost time in a very respectable first section, but John, it's a fairly tall order for him.
Yeah, it certainly is, Chris, and it's quite interesting though, this time of 2:56.54 by Ian Wiley would have put him second in the first heat. It just shows the depth in this second heat and the speed these guys are going to qualify. It's so exciting. I don't think we can write anyone off now, you know. I mean, any of these lads can qualify.
Well, this is a very much shorter course, remember, than the first, but demanding huge amounts of concentration. He's coming across now to the targets, which haven't presented any problem. In fact, turned him around rather nicely, although he's fighting here now to keep on course.
Yeah, he ended up, I think he almost forgot the second target there and had to go back for it. He took that wave very nicely indeed, got up there. Paddles very similar to Jimmy Jays at the first heat, this lad. Coming down now through the last gate, sprinting to the finish line. He's not going to win it, but he might be in there.
And Michael Reyes, the paddle up and over, finishing in a time of 2:58.47. The determination on the face of Peter Mickler, fourth after the first section, and John Gosling, your overseas favourite, I think.
Yeah, but did you see the way he left the start there? He was just trying to go so fast. Peter is amazing at times. He really... Oh, and he's just hit the pole. I mean, just trying too hard, I think, there, Chris. Anyway, he's coming back now. He's still going to go for it. He's really going.
Well, he has to now, because that's the first time, I think, we've seen any faults incurred on this part of the course. But, well, if anyone can do it, it'll be Mickler, because he's never going to give up until the very end. He's coming across now for the targets. Oh, and he's in trouble also at the targets. Got his tangled up with his paddle, but he's got out of that all right, and now coming across to the gates.
Yeah, I think he's tried to do it too fast. He's come down the course. He's tried to do it too fast. He's picked up a five. But he's still up there. He's an incredibly fast time. We can't write anyone off, you know. He's coming to the last gate now, turning out the last gate and approaching the finish line. He's just got that 1.5, I think, Chris.
He's got that, but the time isn't too great. The paddle goes up. He made no mistake about that. 3:00.72, but he's got five penalty points to add to that. Richard Fox, the defending champion, almost 10 seconds down on Melvin Jones after the first section. This should really be something. Let's see the determination here and the wonderful style of Richard Fox as he tries to make up for lost time. Is he going to do it?
I tell you what, he's really trying hard. He really came across those snakes very quick indeed. He's turning on the power a lot more than he did in the first half of the heat. And I'll be interested to see what he does on this move here, because I actually thought he'd go in the straight move and try and ride along the stopper waves there, the waves turning back on themselves. But he almost made a mistake. He's in that really heavy water there, and now he's coming back. He knows this move, as you say, it was his downfall at the World Championships. Let's see if he does it clear. This was my tip for the winner, but who knows?
Well, it's far from Richard Fox's title this time. Things are not been going all that well for him. He's now coming down. There's the time. He's racing towards the finishing line, up and over. 2 minutes, 53.05, and a clear run. Marjan Struko from Yugoslavia has Richard Fox's 2 minutes 53.05 to beat, but if anyone can do it, it's this young man, immensely talented.
He'd dearly love to take the scalp of Fox for a second time, I tell you. And he's cleared the pirouette section and turning out of it now, and he's on his way over. 2:53.05 to beat, that's the time. Fox did this course in 52 seconds on his run. We'll have to see. He's coming down now. Oh, and he's lost time there, but he has a lot of time over Fox. Remember, 4 seconds he was faster than him on the first half of the heat.
The bronze medal in the World Championships, second in the team event. He's got so much going for him. He's coming across now into the gates.
Yeah, now the thing is, it's with him and with Melvin. They've both got to be careful that they don't go too slow trying to get the course clear, because Fox has set the time for him to beat. So he's gone through the last gate. I'm sure he's clear up to now, and he's just heading for the finish line.
And it's a good time as he comes up to the finishing line. Up and over goes the paddle. The paddle didn't go over. It went up, not over. 2 minutes 51.67, but he's got the 5 penalty points there at the finishing line. So Melvin Jones, the fastest time in the heat. And he knows, whatever happens, that Richard Fox, the defending champion, is going to be there, snapping at his heels in the final.
Yeah, and he has to beat 2:56.54, which is Ian Wiley, is in second place at the moment. Melvin, the same situation here. He's got to go clear, but he can't go slow. And this is what happens. When they slow up, they tend to become... They're not as good. Look, he's slow there. He's not paddling his normal speed. It'd be going through his mind all the time. I've got to be clear, I've got to be clear. Did the target nicely, though, and now Jones has got a power across.
So it's the positive approach, John, even at this stage.
That's right, yeah, you can't ease off. Look how low he's in the breakout. I tell you, it's in his mind. He's thinking, I've got to get through to the final.
And time gone there, certainly, so he's got to now start to go some, just to make sure that he can get into the final. What a terrible waste it would be if he didn't, but surely he will. He's negotiated that well, and only disaster could prevent it. Well, he did it, and he's got a good time. He held on, almost in relief to the paddle. 2 minutes, 46.84, he's through to the final. And so the winners of Heat 2 and through to the final. Melvin Jones, 2:46.84. Richard Fox, the defending champion, 2:53.05. The other times, Wiley, 2:56.54. Struckel, 2:56.67. Rees, 2:58.47. Mickler, 3:05.72. And Ruspin, 3:06.
So some tremendous excitement and entertainment. And poor Abramich from Yugoslavia, who would have thought that he would have failed by not getting his paddle up over the finishing line. Exactly the same thing that happened to Richard Fox 2 years ago. But it's Fox, the defending champion, who gets through, and along with him, the winner of the heat, Melvin Jones. So the British success story continues. Now in Heat 3, we have the ladies and a tremendous field in which Liz Sharman, the defending champion and world champion, pits her skill against, among others, Miriam Gerusalmi, number two in the world, and the exciting young German girl.
Now is North Wales for the ladies' heat in the whitewater canoeing competition, Paddles Up.
Welcome back to the delightful River Dee at Llangollen for Paddles Up. Now we know the four men finalists.
Jimmy Jay's 29, Ian Ruspin, Richard Fox, Melvin Jones, age 23.
This is Heat 3, the ladies' heat, and believe me, it's a formidable array of talent. So let's go to the start and have a rundown on the paddlers for Heat 3.
16-year-old Heather Corrie, the youngest competitor, bronze medal in her first ever Junior World Championships. Maria Francis, 18 years of age, second in the European Junior Championships. Gail Allen, never missed a paddles up and has won it twice. Karen Davis, ranked 2 in Great Britain, 5th in the World Championships. Elizabeth Mickler, 21-year-old sister of Peter, world team champion, 3rd in the individual event. Miriam Gerusalmi, French ladies champion, silver medalist in the World Championships. Liz Sharman, the reigning world, European and British champion, and defending her paddles up title. the first of the ladies in the form of 16-year-old Heather Corrie, the youngest in the event from Marple in Cheshire. Bronze medal in her first ever Junior World Championships in 86. Going up to the roll gate, slowly through, or was she through?
She almost took the underwater cameraman out there, but she did it well. I mean, tremendous to see these young girls coming down on this course. She's not expected to win, but she's not expected to come last, she said to me.
Well, it'll be fascinating to see just how the ladies negotiate what is, remember, the self-same course as the men have had trouble with. Is she coming up now to the pirouette? Does that very well, and such determination on that face of Heather Corrie, 16 years of age. A delight to see her on the water.
It'll be nice to see if the girls can actually clear the course where all the men's heats failed. But you know, Chris, the nice thing about this is the only event in the world where we let the girls and the guys compete together in the same event, because two of these girls are going to go through with the four lads into the final, and we're going to have men and ladies in the final.
Let's see then what the first of the ladies can do with the limbo gates, which caused so many problems for the men, particularly this one coming up. And Heather's going slowly but very surely through, and she's done that beautifully. She's through it, and she's going now across down to the 360 degree turn and causing a little bit of problems for her there, the strength of that water. But she's going cannily, she's going soundly.
Yeah, the stopper wave there is the wave that turns back on itself. She's lost it slightly at the end, and all the back ends in the stopper, she could be in trouble. She's going to have to move round into the slacker water now, the eddy there just between it, and power back up. She's got to get this gate. She was having such a good run to that mark of time.
And Heather carried on down the course clear, a marvellous run, finishing in 2 minutes 46.42. This is the 18-year-old Maria Francis from the Stafford and Stone Club, which produced the likes of Richard Fox. She took to the sport by watching Paddles Up in 1985, and she's made quite incredible progress. Winner of the Junior World event in Spain and second in the European Junior Championship. She's ranked seventh in Great Britain, John.
Yeah, she's come on tremendously. In fact, she's a member of the Welsh squad as well. She's a Welsh girl, and not only representing Britain, but representing Wales as well, which is tremendous. It's so good to see her at this event, and I think she is one of the real up-and-coming stars. You know, I think we're going to see her for a long, long time to come. But she's on the pirouette now, and she's attempted it and really not done very well there. But just because she just can't get the boat up quite high enough, they're all having trouble with it, as we've said, but she's off now, over towards the targets.
So a determined but a fairly nervous start for Maria Francis. It's a daunting prospect, this, and she's taking, very wisely, just taking her time, not risking anything for speed, but just taking her time and going methodically down the course.
Yeah, she's moving down now towards the limbo section, where we've just, I mean, it's amazed us, really, if you think about it, that we thought it'd be the easiest bit, and they're all hitting the second limbo.
Yes, it's the second one that's been causing the problem. She's coming up now to the first. We'll see how she negotiates that. That's no problem with that. Now, this is the one that's been causing so many problems for all the paddlers. Cleared that. That was very nicely done. So this is, she seems to have recovered her composure.
Yeah, she's going quite well, really. She's got the stopper right now, which is the wave where it turns back on itself. And she's wisely pulling off that now and coming across below it and then power up towards the green downstream gate.
But of course, there's tremendous danger lurking for her lower down, isn't there?
Yeah, there certainly is at the tail. I mean, that is where the crunch move is. Those gates there, the breakout and so on, is the real crunch.
She's coming now down to the fast section, which will take her up to this ring. And this has certainly caused problems in the past. And she's having a little bit of difficulty here, John.
Yeah, she's broken out, and now she's got to pass a paddle through. And she's in incredible... Oh, she's got a paddle stuck. She's incredibly... She's in the wrong position. She's down in the hole there, and she needs to get across to do the right-hand breakout.
Oh, she's looking very nervous indeed. In fact, she hasn't gone across to do the breakout, so she's missed that. She's now overturned, and she's in desperate trouble. And as a result of missing out on the breakout, oh, she's so disappointed, and she's disqualified. Now, here's a familiar face, 22-year-old Gail Allen, winner twice previously of Paddles Up, eighth in the World Championships in 87, and retired after that, but we've tempted her back out of retirement, and it's marvellous to see her in her fourth Paddles Up, but she's hit the first gate, so problems early on for Gail Allen, who may, John, just be lacking a little bit of practice.
Yeah, I think she's lacking paddling practice, but she's certainly fit. She's been doing a lot of training for other sports, but... we'll see. I mean, the general fitness is there, the paddling fitness I don't think is there. But she approaches the pirouette now. In the past, she's hated it, and looks to be the same again.
And in the future she's going to hate it because she's had her two compulsory attempts at it, decided to waste no more time. Finished third in the 85 championships and might have expected to do a little bit better in France in 87. Oh, she nearly came adrift there on the first of the two targets, but she's righted herself. And that may have lost her a little bit of enthusiasm, but she's back here, John, and of course part of the whole joy of this is just the fun of competing.
That's right, yeah. Although they all say they don't mind not winning, but they want to win, but it's fun to enjoy. She comes down under the first limbo there now, approaching the second one. This is the one that's been causing problems for the men, but oh, she's missed that, Chris. She's gone straight past it.
Well, that's a 50 penalty points in that case, because missing an obstacle is immediately 50 penalty points, so that has put her in an impossible situation, although she's paddling pretty well or straightforward at the moment. But, oh, she's hit that pole again with her head. So a disappointing run for Gail Allen, twice winner of Paddles Up in the past. She finished with 65 penalty points in a total time, 3 minutes, 21.68. Next on the slide, 21-year-old Karen Davis from the Forest of Dean, ranked two in Britain, and a very confident young lady this, because, John, she didn't bother with a practice run.
No, we'll have to see if it's paid off not taking a practice run. As she approaches the roll gate now, goes over nicely. Oh, and she's pulled the gate forward with the paddles, almost demolished the gate, took the underwater housing out as well. Oh, God, I'd hate to be that diver there.
She's having a tremendous season, though, fifth in the World Championships, and this is her third Paddles Up, so she's very familiar with the format, and she will certainly be familiar with the next obstacle, which is the pirouette, but which has caused a few problems. Now, will Karen, a slight young lady, be able to have the strength to get up? Not at the first time, not at the second. Deciding, though, I think very wisely, John, just to cut her losses and head straight for the target.
Yeah, she takes the five there to add to the five on the roll gate, so she's got 10 seconds penalties already. I don't think the targets, although she's stuck in the eddy there, the slack water, she gets caught up in that, takes the two targets out now and moves down to the limbo section.
It's just a question now of whether she has the strength really to cope with the hardest part of this course, because she isn't very strong of build.
No, she's not a very big girl, but she knows she has the experience, she has the skill. Moves into the limbos, clears the first one. I think she'll get the second one, no trouble, because she's so small, as you say. Oh, the kiss of death comes in. She's picked up 15 seconds penalties already as she approaches the 360-degree turn and the stopaway.
You're never going to get a job as a fortune teller, that's for sure, John. But anyway, she's managing around the 360-degree turn. Comes across now, and this will be a test of her strength if she can hold that. She hasn't managed to hold it. She's lost a bit of time, lost a bit of ground, and will have to fight her way back to see if she can get round this gate without further penalties. And Karen Davis went on to finish in a time of 2:40.69 plus 15 penalty points. Next away, Elisabeth Mickler, the 21-year-old sister of Peter from Bavaria, third in the World Championships at her very first attempt, and recognised as one of the outstanding lady paddlers in the world, and certainly beautifully through the first of the obstacles.
Yeah, not only was she third in the individual, she is the current world team champion as well, so she's a world champion in her own right. It was tremendous to see her performance at the World Championships. And like Peter, you know, the phone went, she picked it up, and they're on the plane. She's been looking forward to it. Like Karen Davis, she didn't bother with a practice run. She said it was too cold and she knew what she was doing. She'd been paddling the water for a few days before this event, but she's having trouble with the pirouette, and this is where they should have got on and practiced.
Well, this is such a strange obstacle for most of them, a bit of a novelty, but great fun, and of course has practical value as well. Peter, Liz's brother, obviously had a tremendous influence on her coaching. She's been in this sport, she was telling me, for 10 years and has wonderful facilities, of course, at Augsburg, the best in Europe. And she's clobbered both of the targets, no problem with that. You can clobber these all right without incurring any penalty points. The time to beat that of young Heather Corries, the youngest in the field as far as the women concerned, 2:46.42. But Elisabeth Mickler picked up five penalty points already, although she's going steadily and very nicely now through the first of the limbos and under, we hope, the second. Let's see what she can do there. Well, she went forward and made an awful mess of it, covered that with her back.
Yeah, she did the wrong move there. I think leaning back is definitely the one, and you can keep your eye on the limbo. But she's round the 360, shooting across the stopper here. Very nicely indeed she did that. Shows her white water experience there, where the stopper wave, turning back on itself, uses the force of the water to help her across, comes flying over and through the limbo, gets a mouthful of water within there and comes down to this tail section, the whip of the serpent, as they call it. through the gate. Oh, we lose her completely there, and she's completely offline now for the tube.
Well, she's in the very worst spot, but tremendous strength there, John, as she recovered, and she's going back now to try and get through or paddle through that tube, but she really looked as if she was in trouble there.
Yeah, she's got herself too far over in the slack there, the eddy, as we call it, but she showed her whitewater experience. Passes at paddles, and she's almost over there, does a deep recovery stroke, and we expected more problems like that, but she recovered so well, and she's so powerful, this girl.
In the meantime, though, seconds are ticking away, and she's got now to put in a very fast finish if she's going to overhaul Heather Corrie, but she's just showing enormous strength and determination, and so, like so many of the Europeans, hasn't competed for about 6 weeks, so a little bit rusty and perhaps a little bit tired, but she's fighting to the very end, time though going away from her. So Liz Mickler finishes with a time of 2 minutes 45.38 plus 10 penalty points. Now we have Miriam Gerusalmi, one of the most decorative of the ladies, competing in paddles up, and she slides in very gracefully. Second in the World Championship, she, John, also having a marvellous season and safely under the roll gate.
Yeah, but she went, I was just going to say, she could be in trouble. She went incredibly deep. The Chris Wright kiss of death comes in, but she's up and she's going now. And it's going to be very close, I think, between Miriam and Liz in this ladies' heat. And I know both of them really want to take the men on in the final. So it's all open. I mean, Heather Corrie, the youngster, could come through if these girls make mistakes at the top end. And remember that Heather is the only person who paddles up so far to clear the course.
That pirouette, though, beautifully done. It really is extraordinary, the concentration that's required, just when you think that the most dangerous part of the hazard has been negotiated. There are more things just to pop up and trap you. And Miriam just lost a little bit of concentration, but she's recovered it well now, did the pirouette beautifully, and is moving on nicely downstream.
You can see she's still shaking her head there, trying to clear the water from her head, really, because it is so cold. When they go over, the brain is stunned. Coming down to the two limbos now, and I know Richard Fox, who they go out together, Miriam and Richard, has been telling her what to do on these, and it certainly helps. She's cleared both of those limbos as she comes down to the 360 before she rides across the stopper. Is she going to take the stopper, which is this wave that turns back on itself, or drop down? She's dropped down, the same as the top men there.
I hesitate to mention it to John, but after her start, she's now making a very, very creditable finish. This is good stuff.
Yeah, she's taking it nice and steady, she's going to be looking now to really sort of power down here. This is where the strength and the experience will come in. Through that gate, positioning the boat now to break high. She's in exactly the right position. Brilliant, brilliant.
Well, we only have the one clear run so far, that of Heather Corrie, the youngest competitor in the event. And Miriam lost the place here a little bit on that 360-degree turn, but still, she's going very well, and the time is not beyond her.
No, she's very respectable. Oh, and she lost it slightly there, but she's coming down to the finish line now. She's going to take the lead, I think, Chris, in 2:15.86 and clear.
And here is the world's leading lady, Liz Sharman, to see if she can join the only two clear rounds in the competition so far, both of them done by the ladies. Liz Sharman, the reigning world champion, European champion, British champion, out on her own. Tremendous strength. She's under the roll gate, really, which she doesn't like very much because it's not done in competition, but she really mastered that beautifully, as she's mastered most things in this game.
That's right, yeah, she's the reigning paddles up champion, so she's defending the title here this year. Talking to her before this, she was saying that she really believes she can beat the men. She really does. Look at that. I mean, she does it twice. She does it once and then just does it. Oh, she's tied her paddles up and she's in real trouble there. Gonna be very, very angry. She'll complain to the organizers that it was our fault, I'll tell you, Chris.
Well, how often have we said that they have completed a hazard, and she's in trouble here as well. And it's quite extraordinary. The two targets have hardly caused any problems for anybody else, but they have for the greatest paddler in the world as far as the women are concerned. She's so determined, such is her determination, that after a disappointing showing in the 1985 World Championships, she went straight to the course where the 87 Championships were to be held, just so that she could practice and get the feel of the water, and then of course came away with the gold medal. Magnificent competitor, and now going well under the limbo gates, under this particular second which has caused so much trouble. And now this is a maneuver where all her strength should show. I hesitate almost to say it, John, but she does have enormous strength.
Oh yeah, she's so powerful. The technique she has is amazing. And you've got to remember, she's still clear. You know, she's very upset with herself. That's why she hammered those targets. But she's still clear. And Liz, in fact, has actually been not in a slalom boat very much recently because she's been practicing for sprint canoeing for the Olympics. Oh, and she's rolled. She's over. She's up. She's going to have to work hard now. Sharma makes a mistake there. That's quite rare.
Well, now, this will require all her determination and strength to get back because she rolled in the very, very worst part of that fast water. She's going round now. She's passing and remaining calm, but almost loses the place again. She's managed to readjust, to get back on an even keel, and time now beginning to tick away. She has apparently had it in the bag, but now she's going to have to go some.
She'll know what the other girls have done now, because the message will have come up the course. She's approached the last gate, she's clear, and she's not going to take the lead, but she's well up there.
Well, that just shows you how remarkable a paddler this is. She finishes in a time of 2 minutes 25.11, and another clear round for Liz Sharma. So at the halfway stage of the third heat, Miriam Gerusalmi leads 2 minutes 15.86. Liz Sharman second, 2:25.11. Heather Corry, 2:46.42. Elizabeth Mickler, 2:55.38. Karen Davis, 2:55.69. Gail Allen, 3:21.68. And a distraught Maria Francis disqualified for failing to finish the course. We pick up the second section with the first of the serious contenders for a place in the final. That's Elizabeth Mickler, 21-year-old, third in the World Championships, but she's got so much to do, more than 30 seconds behind the heat leader, Miriam Gerusalmi.
She can really go if she has to. She's coming down now. I think it's a bit more than 10 seconds, but the thing is that anything can happen. You know, she's done the snake very good. You know, the men were not much faster than she was. There was only sort of Fox who really flew the snake section. And she will have spoken to Peter, her brother, who's here today watching, and is helping her out. He's already done the course. He's had the advantage in his heat. Did it, and therefore he's come back to help his sister try and get into the final.
Well, we've talked about the tremendous power of this young lady, and she's certainly going to require all that, and she's in trouble right away here at the target.
Yeah, now it's whether she tries to come up and get it or just thinks 5 seconds. It's going to take her far more than 5 seconds to come back up here. She's got to realise quick, she's on the rock, she's in real trouble. In fact, if she goes down there, she could end up anywhere. She's having to come below the gates now at the bottom. This move we had from the Worlds, and she's in real trouble. I mean, she's in real trouble, so therefore anything can happen.
Well, this is a disastrous run. She's missed the second of the targets. She's missed altogether the gates and having to come plough her way back up through this raging torrent to try and make amends and repair some of the damage, but the time ticks on.
Yeah, but if she can do it, the others could make the same mistake, so therefore she's got to keep going to the end. She's done well, she's pulled back, being a short course, so she's now going to the end with just this 5 seconds off the target, Chris.
She's up to the finishing line. The paddle goes over at 4 minutes 25.97 with 5 penalty points to add to that. And here's 16-year-old Heather Corry, the youngest in the event. And what a marvellous first section she had, finishing in third place. A marvellous start for her in paddles up.
Oh, and she just hit the gate there, Chris, as you said it. I mean, never mind, you know, she had a tremendous start. First person to clear the first half in all the heat. And she's picked up a couple there. And that just shows how difficult this section is. You know, the paddlers have very little time to recover from that long session earlier into this short course here, which is about the 52nd. And now she's coming down, she's getting real encouragement. There's a lot of people here to watch her and try and give her as much encouragement as possible, shouting her down the course. She's obviously feeling a bit tired. She's had an injury, but she's come back and she's working hard.
I fancy that no matter what happens on this occasion, we'll see her many times more in the paddles up. And she's done that beautifully, both targets, and hit the water coming across very well indeed.
For a young 16-year-old girl there, driving across that sort of water, and grit and determination on her face, you know. I mean, as you say, she's going to be here many times. Oh, she's just clipped another gate. She must be incredibly tired as she comes down here. She's picked up a few penalties and coming towards the finish line.
Yeah, she's got 15 penalty points, but she's never given up. She throws the paddle up. Oh, it just went over. Well done. And she finishes 3 minutes 55.56, but there are 15 penalty points to add to that. The world champion, Liz Sharman, just under 10 seconds behind Miriam Gerusalmi in this heat, but to John Gosling, it'll be some of the men that Liz will be wanting to beat, I fancy, not just the ladies.
That's it. I mean, she spoke to me in the gap and she said that she really wants to win the heat. You know, she's seen the prizes, she wants them, she wants to win the heat. She's she has the capability of pulling back 9 seconds, but only if Miriam makes a mistake ever so slightly. I don't really see it happening, but what she has to do is stay in front of this time of 4:10 by Heather Corrie. You know, she's lying third, Heather. Tremendous for a young girl.
Yes, let's not forget that. But the world champion has got to do pretty well, even to beat that. But she's coming across now, and I would fancy that she's not going to allow herself to be beaten in this.
She's coming up now. She's got plenty of time in hand. She can't afford to make mistakes, but likewise, she's got to keep moving. She looks as though she's going to clear the course. To this point, she's got the paddles up to go, and she's got to keep going.
But that's a very respectable time for the defending champion, Liz Sharman, 3:26.57. Miriam Gerusalmi, the French ladies champion, she knows now what she's got to do. She's watched Liz Sharman, the defending champion, go down in front of her. And as you were saying, John, really just care is the name of the game. But at the same, by the same token, we've seen so many negative approaches here. And it's obviously disastrous if you take it too easily.
That's right. Miriam, very careful there going across. And she has to keep going. This time of 4:10, which is Heather's time after her total run, she's got to keep in front of that, but she'll want to beat Liz, the 3:56.47 that Liz has done. And interestingly enough, Liz is the only person to clear the whole course, the both sides of the course, in all the heats. Oh, and Miriam's missed a target. She's missed two targets. This is going to be really interesting, Chris, because she's got one of them, so she's got a five-second penalty.
Well, we'll see what she can do now, but there's absolutely no room for manoeuvre now. She can't make any more mistakes, otherwise the young Heather Corrie could well get herself through to the final. This is going to be fascinating now as she negotiates this very tricky part.
You can see tensions on her face. Look, she's making mistakes. She knows she has to keep going. She knows she can't afford penalties. So it's 4:10 is Corrie's time, and she's approaching the finish line now.
Let's see what she does. Well, she's got that over and a delighted, relieved to do so. 3:24.71 with 5 penalty points for Miriam Gerusalmi. And so the winners of that marvellously entertaining ladies' heat, Liz Sharman, the defending champion, 3:26.57. Miriam Gerusalmi, 3:29.71. Heather Corrie, 4:10.56. Mikkola, 4:30.97. Allen, 4:33.60. And Karen Davis, 4:56.58.
And so the top two ladies in the world are through to the final of Paddles Up, Liz Sharman and Miriam Gerusalmi. And there they'll join the four British men, Jimmy Jays, Richard Fox, Ian Raspin and Melvin Jones. So don't forget to join us for the final of Paddles Up.
Grand final of the International Whitewater Canoeing Competition. Paddles Up.
Welcome back to the final of Paddles Up for the Norwich Union Trophy. We are here on the River Dee at Llangollen. We started with the strongest field ever assembled for Paddles Up, so it's no surprise that we've got the best ever final. We've got three world champions, and John Gosling, that really is something.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'm so pleased. You know, it's been a tremendous series to date.
Now, one or two of your favourites have fallen by the wayside, so who's your favourite now?
I thought you might ask me that. I've still got to stick with Fox, haven't I? He's still there. I mean, how he does it, I have no idea, but I've got to stick with him. The outsider, JJ, Jimmy Jays.
Well, we'll soon find out. Let's go up now to the start and have a rundown on the paddlers for the final of this year's Paddles Up.
Miriam Gerusalmi, second in the World Championships, reigning French ladies champion and coached by Richard Fox. Jimmy Jays, the local boy from Llangollen, former British champion and current British team champion. Liz Sharman, you name it, she's won it. World, European and British champion and defending Paddles Up champion. Melvin Jones, world team champion, ranked third in Britain and an ever-present in Paddles Up. Ian Raspin, ranked two in Britain and a member of Britain's World Championship team. Richard Fox, defending his Paddles Up title. 3 times world champion and reigning world team and European champion. Miriam Gerusalmi, the French ladies champion, ranked 2 in the world, gets the final of Paddles Up underway, down the slide and across to the first of the downstream gates.
Yeah, it's a short course, this, Chris. We're expecting it to be about 60 seconds. She has to come right the way across in what looks like flat water. It's flowing incredibly quick. Simple downstream gate, but how they do it, whether they do it forwards or reverse, it doesn't matter as long as they're downstream. Now they're back into the middle for the pirouette gate. And she's missed that, and she's going to have to go round again. She's in real trouble now.
Compulsory 2 attempts, so she's had to go all the way around, and it looks to me as if that pirouette is set very high. It's going to be very difficult and catch a few out, but she's wasting a lot of time here. Well, she's gone round for the second time, has failed again and decided not to waste any more time, and she goes now down to the 360-degree turn.
That's right, pole in the middle of the river. It's positioned as much to really make them work to get back over to the left-hand bank now, where there's a target which they have to hit and then ride down the slight stopper here, which is the wave that turns back on itself, rides across the current and down that gate, gets a 5 there. And now this 360-degree gate here is so difficult. It's a pole, and there she goes. She dips the front end and has real trouble. That sort of standing wave stopper, it's higher than a normal stopper and doesn't drop as fast. And it's there, and the idea is that they'll have to do straight round it in one move if possible. Miriam does it a second attempt, collects a 5 and gets stuck in the stopper and goes through the last gate there.
Well, this certainly is a course worthy of the final of the Paddles Up. It's proved too difficult for Miriam Gerusami. She finishes 1 minute 31.14, but she has 10 penalty points to add to that. Liz Sharman, the current world champion, in her bid to retain her Paddles Up title, and off she goes. How fascinating it'll be to see just how she negotiates the tricky stage of this final, which really proved too much for Miriam Gerusalmi. But we know Liz is a tremendously fierce and a very strong competitor.
Yeah, she's moving towards the pirouette now. She's holding the boat down and she's missed it, so she's got to go round again. We gave the paddlers a practice run on this, Chris, and when we were there watching them, they were all hitting the ball, no trouble. It's just when it comes into competition, they make that mistake, and she's done it again.
And she never got near that. Once again, like Miriam, she's decided that she's not going to waste any time on it, and it seems to be an extremely difficult hazard to negotiate. She's negotiated the 360-degree turn all right, and now she comes across to the next of the gates.
Yeah, now she's coming down towards the target area, and she's wisely so. She's going to use the full length of her paddle, almost goes over, so that she's in a better position to get this. Oh, and she hits a rock underwater there. Could have damaged the boat even there, but now she's got this 360-degree pole to negotiate now. She's coming towards it, and she's got to ride across and then come back down on the stopper. Brilliant.
She's done that absolutely superbly, if she can clear it, which she has, and all she's got at the moment is a failure on the pirouette. Now, that's a marvellous finish for Liz Sharman, and with some relief, she goes over the finishing line, 1 minute 18.44, and just the 5 penalty points. Jimmy Jays, the local lad from Llangollen, making good. He's in the final, and we're delighted to see him there. He's 29, the most experienced, or one of the most experienced paddlers in the field. He's been at it for 18 years, and he must know every inch of this water, I should think.
Yeah, we're back up on what we call a nomad stretch, and this is JJ's home water. If he can't do these moves, no one can. That's what I say. But, oh, and he goes so high, he almost headbutts the ball, and he's missed it. He's going to have to come round again.
He was certainly high enough, but he wasn't quite in the perfect position for it, and he's lost a lot of time there. He really went far downstream, and look how far he's had to come back. And, oh, the strain is beginning to tell on his face. He's decided again that there's no point in wasting any more time. Down he goes to the 360-degree turn, and once again, John, he's lost a lot of time on that pirouette.
Yeah, you can hear the crowd shouting him down, the locals really trying to get him down there, and he was the kiss of death, wasn't it? You know, said he could do it, and but anyway, he's down now. Now he's going down to this green gate, the downstream gate, and then the pirouette, the 360-degree pole. So excited, Chris. And this will be the move. This will be the move. This is JJ's move. Let's see if he can do it.
Here he comes then, across this treacherous stretch for him, and the 360, and he's not certainly wasted any time on that. Oh, but he's got a little bit too close to it still. He's safely around it, and now through the final gate, downstream gate, and on his way to the finishing line, which he's crossed 1 minute to 21.36, but once again, 5 penalty points to add to that. Richard Fox, the defending champion. What's he going to make of this? Down the slide he goes, and comes across with tremendous determination on that face to the first of the gates.
Look at his eyes, they're evil, aren't they? He's really burning, and let's see if he can get his ball in one. He was so upset in the heat. He came up and spoke to us and said, I'm really fed. Oh, and he almost demolishes the ball in making sure he hits it.
I think he's making sure that none of the others have to do it. He always took it down with him, but there was no doubt about that. The thing that scuppered him in the heats is certainly not going to let him do it. Let him do it to him again. And he's on his way now to the targets, and this is very good time.
Yeah, you see, he's eased off now. He's taken the pace off, trying to get the line right for this gate here. Now we'll see him accelerate slightly when he's on the wave. Watch, see the paddle rate go up. Now he's going to really drive across this stopper wave again there, brilliantly round, through the last gate. I think he's clear as he goes to the finish.
What a marvellous competitor. The first so far of the clear runs, and look at that time for Richard Fox. He really is out to win this title again. 57.06 seconds, a marvellous run. Go! That's Ian Ruspin, the 20-year-old student from Trent College, chasing that formidable target set by Richard Fox as he races across to the first gate.
Yeah, you see, he's powering as well. These guys, these Brits, we've got four British guys in the final, which is tremendous. But, I mean, they're out to beat one another as much as possible. Oh, and Ruspin's missed the ball! Now, absolutely. I mean, what's this going to do to his time? I mean, Fox has broke 60 seconds. It's a short course. I mean, he's really going to be struggling. He can't afford a five, which he hasn't got now.
Did it beautifully the second time, but of course they're now under tremendous pressure as a result of that superb run by Fox. Under a minute, and that really is that's going to be the target to beat. And it's, is it beatable? This is the question. I doubt that it's going to be beaten by Ruspin, but he'll give it all he's got, no doubt, in the closing stages. He's certainly got the target, but he seems to have lost his rhythm slightly.
Yeah, I think he's a bit disjointed now. He pulled that well. We see the way the back end of the boat went down. Now he can save time here. Fox lost a bit of time here, I think. And Ruspin is faster. Ruspin was definitely faster. Although he's down on Fox's time, he was faster on that move, so he just needs to keep moving.
And so Ian Ruspin finishes in 1 minute 08.35 and a clear run. So Melvin Jones in his fifth paddles up, the last man down the slide. In he goes and across, and what a time he has to beat, under a minute, set by Richard Fox. But look at the determination here. If anyone can do it or is going to try and do it, it's Melvin Jones.
Yeah, this is the crucial move now. He's got to get the pirouette, and Melvin really wants to do it. Fastest man in the heat, remember, that's why he's going off last. And oh, he's missed the ball. Oh my God, it's a crucial move, and that's where Fox did it. He's got to hit the ball now. He can't afford a 5 second penalty. But we've got to remember, oh, and he's missed the ball. We've got to remember, though, Chris, there's another half to this final, and I reckon that'll be a longer one.
It's ironic, though, that the very hazard that cost Richard Fox so dear in the heat, he's managed, negotiated with no trouble at all, and that's a measure of the greatness of the man, Richard Fox. But that's a good target hit from Melvin Jones. He must be discouraged, though, immensely by his misfortunes at the pirouette.
Yeah, but he'll keep going, Melvin will, and he's just got to keep the boat moving, which is the name of the game in slalom. Keep the boat moving at all times. He's up, he's round there, he's clear there. He's just got that 1.5 as he goes towards the finish line.
But well down on Richard Fox. Melvin Jones finishes in a time 1 minute 09.85 and 5 penalty points. And so the times at the halfway stage of the final. Fox, 57.06 seconds. Ruspin, 1 minute 08.35. Jones, 114.85. Sharman, 123.44. Jays, 126.36. And Gerusalmi, 141.14. Miriam Gerusalmi, the slowest after the first section of the final, starts the second. Now, we've moved down to the town site at Llangollen, and John Gosling, I think without any question, it's the hardest course yet set.
Yeah, we've put a pole, red and white pole there, which is a traditional slalom pole, to guide them over the fall, and now they're going to three normal slalom gates over the pot. And you can see the foaming white water there. They're semi-staggered, fairly easy. Well, Miriam made it look easy, but it's tremendous, powerful water. Now we come down to the mill and the town fall, and this is a superb piece of course here. Alan Edge's come up with a brilliant one. Under a limbo, hit a target, and there she gets a five. She gets the target, and now she's got to get across the other side of the fall to pass a paddle through a tube. And you can see there Miriam in all sorts of problems, and she is the second best lady in the world. And the thing is, this course is so wide open now that she can take Liz on it, I think.
Well, a frail figure she is in the maelstrom, but the point I think we should make watching this, John, is that although Richard Fox has a tremendous lead after the first stage, anything really can happen. So difficult is this course, and even to the greatest.
That's right, yeah, there's two 360-degree poles here designed as a figure of eight for them. Oh, and she's in trouble, she's ended up going right under the bridge there. That's an amazing place to end up.
Miriam, where are you? Come back. Here she is, coming back now to the tractor tower. Tell us about that, because we haven't seen this for a while in Paddles Up.
No, we had it in the first ever Paddles Up in Llangollen, and we've put it back in, hanging off the bridge. Bit of a fun thing for the paddlers, but now there's a long slog down this flattish bit under three limbos. Does the first one now, two more limbos to go before the bottom fall. And these limbos are high and low so that the paddlers don't really know where they are, because we've adjusted them since the practice runs.
Now what about this drop here, because this looks fairly dangerous for her. She's coming up to it now, she's ploughing her way through it, but did that well, and now she's got to do the roll, and she's managed that. Is she getting up? Yes, she is. And you can see the water being shaken out of her ears now, just taking a few gulps of breath to get her air, to get her breath back.
That's right. They haven't had much time to recover from the first half. Across now to the standard downstream gate and into a 360-degree orange pole now before the finish. Driving water, the time, anything can be made up.
Well, this is the point that she's going very slowly. It's a slow time, but she's only incurred 5 penalty points. She gets the paddle up. Yes, it goes over just and no more. So she finishes that tremendously hard course with some relief. A time 3:57.92 and 5 penalty points. Well, if anybody should know this course, it's this man. It's Jimmy Jays, the local boy from Llangollen. Certainly one of the most experienced paddlers. And John, he'll know this course pretty well.
Yeah, he doesn't get much chance to be on it, really, because we only have use of the river at certain times, where we negotiate with Llangollen anglers and the townspeople, which have been so supportive of this competition this year. And it's tremendous, but JJ is out. He knows he blew the first half on his actual training site, but he knows he can make it up, as we've said.
Well, he's made a very good start, and he made those gates look remarkably easy. Here he comes now to the limbo, and he's missed the target. Now, he'll have to go back for that. Can he? Oh, he can't. There's no way. He's missed the target. He's totally taken away by that torrent, and that's the target missed, and he was going so well.
That's right. He's picked up the 5. There's no way once they miss it, they're going to get back for that one. And the super thing is now, it's wide open. It is wide open. JJ knows he's got to keep going. He knows he still hasn't blown it, really, but he would have preferred not to have the penalty. See, he's working incredibly hard now, and he's going to have to ease off to go through the tyre, but I think we'll see him accelerate down this bottom stretch below the bridge.
No problem with the tyre. As we were saying earlier, this is a course designed to test the very best, and even Richard Fox in practice was making heavy weather of it. So a lot can happen, and Jimmy Jays is safely under the limbo. Look at the determination on that face. He's going to make up now for that miss of the target, and he's going well enough.
Yeah, he's working hard. It's freezing cold. The water's cold on the hands, and now he's approaching to have to shoot this weir here. Over the weir, Owen is stuck in the stopper there, the wave, it turns back on itself, he's into the stopper, he's into the roll, and he's going to come up very fast, and he's hit the roll gate, so he's picked up another 5 there, so that's 10 seconds of penalties he's got as he approaches the downstream gate. Doesn't matter if he's forwards or backwards, but he's caught now in the difference between the slack and the fast, and he's losing time.
Yes, he's still got a very respectable time, though. He's been going well. If it wasn't for those two, he's no problem at all with the paddle going over the finish. He finishes 3:19.19 with 10 penalty points. So Liz Sharman on the final stage of the defence of her Paddles Up title, but of course it's a competition within a competition for her, because she'll be out to beat some of the men as well. She's got Miriam Gerusalmi's time to beat, which, well, who knows, anything can happen on this course, as we've said before, but she'll certainly be out to beat a few of the men, I think, John.
Yeah, she's coming down now over the pot. Makes the gates look fairly easy. It is an incredibly technical piece of water there, and these paddlers make it look easy. Liz on her practice run went slow, steady, and I think she might try to go a bit faster here because she doesn't know, so it could be interesting on this. We've seen all sorts of things happen. She's under the limbo, hits the target, drops into the hole there, and already having trouble now, fighting her way over to the tube.
Well, you could see her taking a gulp of air. It must be desperately cold in there, but she's doing very well indeed at the moment, and nobody is more mentally attuned to the demands of a course like this than Liz Sharp.
Did you see there, she threw the tube away, going back to the ladies' heat, where she got caught up in the pirouette ball and almost blew it there, and she actually threw it away and thought, I'm not going to get tied up here. But the time she's got to beat of 4:02.92, which is Miriam's time, that's the time she's got to beat to win the ladies, and now she's got to beat JJ, who was 3:19, to at least beat one man.
Well, she's on course for that. That was where Miriam Gerusalmi got horribly lost, literally, under the bridge, and Liz has made no difficulty with the tyre at all. There's obviously a farmer in Llangollen somewhere with only one tyre in his tractor, but it's a marvellous novelty for them. Going under the limbo, the first of the limbos. Now, these limbos were set very low, but Liz Sharman's made light of that. There's one more, and she gets under that very well. Now, she took the forward approach to that, John.
Yeah, she's convinced that that's the best way, and she's very, very precise in the way she plans the run down the course. You see, she's in the roll gate now. She's actually rolled facing the wrong way there. So look, she's disorientated now. She's going to have to work to get across. I mean, she's not going to beat JJ. But the thing is, she's got to beat Miriam, which is 4:02. And time's ticking away here. She's the wrong way round now. She's got to go into a 360 degree on the left. It's going to get close, Chris. I tell you, it's going to be close.
Well, she's not picked up any penalty points that I can recall, so she's that's the time you're seeing at the moment. Remember, Miriam Gerusalmi, 4:02.92, up and over it goes. It just goes over, and she's done it, 3:31.55. So Liz Sharman made a successful defence of her Paddles Up title. Well done, Liz. Melvin Jones, the leader of his heat with the best time and going very well this season, ranked third in Britain. How do you think this course is going to suit him, John?
Well, I spoke to him after the first half and looking at this course, and he said, I'm out of it. And then he saw Fox go down and roll twice and said, I'm back in it. I'm not sure. Oh, he's clipped the gate, trying too hard there. But it's wide open. It really is wide open. He's coming down now. So this is the crunch move. If he can get this bit clear and fast, I think they're all in with a chance. He's done that, done the target, so he's now over to this gate. Now, if he can do this in one, brilliant. That's the move. He's lost time a little because I think he was surprised he got it so good. Now he's coming down, so it's a fast time. I think he's going to beat Jay's, but we'll have to see. But it's what time he can put up that Fox can then go at.
Yes, he's the only one that did that ring properly. The others all came downstream and had to go back. So time made up there for Melvin Jones.
Yeah, now coming down to the tyre, he has to ease off as he comes through the tyre, but then he's got to accelerate. He has to start accelerating now. He knows this is where the tyre can be made up. And now he'll be working hard. He's tired. Remember, they've done the first half of the heat, so therefore they've had very little recovery time before we put them on here. We let them have a practice run down. But now you can see the determination and grit on his face as he's puffing his way down the course.
I think the other point to be made is we're coming to the end of a very long and hard season. These paddlers have been going since early in the new year, so muscles will be tired and concentration tends to go at critical stages. But Melvin Jones making up for the time and the penalty points he lost earlier on, and making his way now across to the closing stages.
Yeah, he's through that gate there and he's broken out too high. He's going to be so unhappy. He's had to go up and back into it here. So time's ticking on. In fact, I don't think he's going to beat Jay-Z's time. He's lost time there as he came down.
Well, he's got five penalty points to add to that. So the time for Melvin Jones, 3:06.85 with the five penalties, and he goes into the lead. Can this man, Ian Ruspin, win his first ever Paddles Up title? Well, he's in second slot behind the great Richard Fox, and look at that face. If determination has anything to do with it, then Ian Ruspin's home and dry.
Yeah, again, all the paddlers have come back from the heats to watch this, and they're all encouraging one another. It is amazing. I know Kiddo, which is Andy Ruspin, Ian's brother who was in the heat, has been here psyching Ian up for this, you know, and saying, you can do it, you can do it. And Ian is so determined. He'd love to get the scalp of Fox and paddles up.
And Father Don, of course, as we've been saying, has been a great influence. He did that very well. Now, let's see what he's done. He's had to go back. He's missed the tyre first time, but he's done it well the second. He's lost a bit of time there.
Yeah, he came so far over for the target, I think, but he's going well. This looks like a very fast run. If he can keep the boat moving all the time, which is the art of slalom paddling, keep the boat moving. Oh, and he hits the pole. He tries to do it too tight. This is where we've been saying in the heat. They don't know whether to go faster or slower, ease off. He knows he's got to put a fast time up there to compete with Fox. But as we say, Fox had so many problems when he had his practice, when we were watching them earlier on the bank, Chris, you know, that anything could happen. Oh, he's hit the limbo now as well.
Yes, that time set by Richard Fox has, of course, put them all under tremendous pressure.
That's right, yeah. He knocked 10 seconds off them. If you remember, it was the pirouette gate that did it. He took the ball in one. And there was a lot of conflict with the paddlers saying, why do we have to attempt it twice? It's because they can cheat, or not cheat, but bend the rule slightly if we do it the other way. But he's into the roll gate now, up a bit slow, shakes his head, and now has to drive over to get across this really fast-moving water.
A case of water on the brain, I think, there for Ian Ruspin, but he's shaking himself clear now, getting his wits back for the closing stages. He's going round the turn, again, lost a little bit there, went too far downstream, now turning and coming up as fast as he can to the finish. Up goes the paddle. 2:58.48, but he has 10 penalty points to add to that. Richard Fox going for his second successive paddles up title for the Norwich Union Trophy, and that's the time he has to beat Ian Raspin, 3:08.48. He had such a fantastic first run, under a minute for Fox, and this man, of course, at his best, is capable of the most extraordinary feats.
Yeah, he took that very sensibly. He eased off at the top. All the other paddlers have driven that part of the water. He eased off. Now he's coming to the limbo. He had trouble when he had his practice. Let's see what he does. He's under the limbo. Hits the target, almost demolishes it. He knows he's the last one down this course. Into the tie now, takes the safe way down the bottom, comes up, look, studied it. Oh, and he's almost over. Anything can happen, Chris.
Yes, we've said it a few times, but it remains true. And there's a long way to go. And Richard Fox is just certainly taking his time. He's not going to risk anything. But of course, again, John, we've seen in the past that the negative approach can be disastrous.
That's right. Yeah, every time it happens, he's got to keep his concentration and he's got to keep moving. And I know he wants to retain the trophy. And therefore, he's coming down now. That's not the Fox burn. That he's taking it steady. He's holding himself. He's turned around and saying, did I hit the limbo? And yes, he did. He's picked up a 5 on the limbo.
Well, we're saying he had all the time in the world. He certainly seems to be taking his time, but he can't afford to pick up any more penalty points if he's going at this pace, I would have thought.
Well, yeah, he's got a mental clock inside him. I tell you, this guy's got a mental clock. He knows exactly what time he's got to do. He's got 5 penalty points. He knows he's got 5 penalty points. That's why he turned around in disgust and looked at the limbo gate as if it was his that fault, you know, the fault of the limbo. But he's coming down. He's now got to go upstream. He's got the 3:08.48 to beat. He's got 5 seconds, Chris.
Yes, he's got this last stage and he's done it. The paddle is up and over. Richard Fox finishes 2:44.87 with 5 penalty points and has retained his paddles up title. And so the final timings. Richard Fox, 2:49.87. Ian Raspin, 3:08.48. Melvin Jones, 3:11.85. Jimmy Jays, 3:29.19. Liz Sharman, 3:31.55, and Miriam Gerusalmi, 4:02.92.
And so Paddles Up has got the winners it deserves, the two greatest paddlers in the world at the moment, Liz Sharman and Richard Fox. And here to make the presentation, first of all to Liz, is Bill Utting, the Assistant General Manager of the Norwich Union. Bill?
There we are, Liz. Many congratulations, a wonderful performance, and there's your trophy.
And now to Richard Fox.
Well done, Richard. Another wonderful performance. Many congratulations.
Thanks very much.
For your sideboard.
And so we come to the end of this year's Paddles Up. We've had excitement, thrills, spills. We've had tremendous competition, but most of all, we've had fun. And I hope, like us, you've had fun. And you'll join us again next year for Paddles Up.